life changed in mere seconds, just a few months after I celebrated that kickboxing victory.
You need to understand the seriousness of your spinal cord injury and come to realize that the movement that you're getting back in your arms is as good as it's gonna get. But what I heard was, you might as well go ahead right now and give up hope. Give up hope in the idea you ever come out of this chair. They would preach two things every day to us. If you're willing to adapt and be a little more flexible than ever before, you can always change the direction and the outcome of your life. I jumped in the passenger side of my buddy's car and off we went. And it wasn't long thereafter when it happened. My friend Ed was driving way too fast. He ran off the road and he crashed into a mound of sand, sending that car hurling into the air before tumbling back to earth end over end. And it was in that one defining moment that everything about my life would change.
One of the first times that I came to a few weeks later, Dr. Stringer walked into my room and he goes, "Scott, I understand you've been complaining. You can't move anything, your arms, your legs." And he goes, "And unfortunately you've broken your neck and you have a very serious spinal cord injury and it has left you paralyzed from your chest down. Diagnosed a quadriplegic."
When I first started pushing a wheelchair, that's when one of my doctors, though, pulled me over. And he goes, "Scott, look, we know you're getting some movement back in your arms. Not uncommon for people who've been diagnosed with quadriplegic. But I think now more than ever, you need to understand the seriousness of your spinal cord injury and come to realize that the movement that you're getting back in your arms is as good as it's gonna get." I don't know if that is exactly what he said, but what I heard was, you might as well go ahead right now and give up hope. Give up hope in the idea you ever come out of this chair. But the problem was, I bought into his words. My vision darkened. To make matters a little more difficult for my parents, they were home. They were 2,000 miles away, and I literally stopped taking their phone calls. 4 days later, Dad got me on the phone and he demanded to know what was wrong. So I made an executive decision to tell him. And all he said was this: "I was out there 2 weeks ago for your birthday. Your attitude was off the charts. Remember how I reached down, put my arms under your arms and hoisted you into the upright position? Do you recall what that felt like?" "Of course I do." "Will you do me a favor? Will you go back and recapture that mindset and re-own it again? In the meantime, don't be upset with me. I'm gonna have words with that doctor." And then come the next morning, when I woke up, I could not believe my eyes. Standing at that doorway, looking back at me, was my dad, letting me know in a sense everything would be okay. And if I learned anything from Dad, whether you're a parent, whether you're part of this family, or a 19-year-old quadriplegic, that no matter how difficult life is for you, in that moment, you can always change your way of thinking. And that's when I made the profound decision that I was willing to fail, but I was unwilling to quit. It's a mindset that can define you as an individual, as a team, as an industry leader, and it's a mindset that can keep you focused while knowing that nothing worth achieving ever comes too easy. Today, if I got out of my wheelchair and I lie down, no matter how hard I try, I cannot do a setup. But back in the day, my lower back muscles returned. I got to a point where I could lean over. When I was able to grab onto that a bit, and it's when I was asking another one of my doctors, you know, the good one. But I was like, hey doc, do you think if I continue to persevere, then maybe one day I'll come out of this chair? And he goes, Scott, look, I'm a fan, but I've never seen it done. And to get you to this point in your life, with all the success that you've had, have you ever met those people that are quick to point out what you may never achieve? Well, there's something I learned in my life so many years ago, and I know it to be the truth. Don't ever let your competition or someone else's beliefs paralyze you from achieving those things you believe in your mind that you just might be able to achieve. Principles of vision, mindset, and grit really came to be after I was paralyzed to help me overcome what seemed to be insurmountable odds. It took me a little over 2,190 days and a tremendous amount of grit to go from a wheelchair to eventually the use of a simple cane. So I'm really trying to say is this, if you're looking to thrive, beat the odds, and achieve extraordinary results in your own life, don't give up too soon. Be willing to see complete success in your mind's eye first. And in doing so, it becomes a belief, which now becomes a reality. So the way I see it, we need to be dreaming in full color in all areas of our lives, and you need to continue doing it until your vision becomes your reality. We can't change the past, but you and I have today. And today we can choose how to respond to a life, a business environment, and a marketplace that simply refuses to stay the same. But change cannot happen successfully unless you are willing to develop the right mindset that is more powerful than all the challenges that are standing in front of you. But what is the right mindset? I believe it begins with an unshakable belief in who you are. It's what you believe about yourself, your abilities, and your skills. And it's what you believe can and will happen while thinking bigger on your own behalf. I believe it takes grit to remain relative in a competitive and a changing world. And it takes grit not to cave in into any of your own self-perceived paralyzing limitations. You find that grit within, man, to stand up to your own life's challenges. Your mindset begins to change, and you start believing you can conquer any mountain standing in front of you. So I have one question to ask all of you. How many of you are now ready to get out of your own chair, so to speak, and stand up to the challenges and the opportunities that you're experiencing in your life, and maybe take action in ways you've never thought about taking action?